positivity brings happiness, and negativity gives sadness. The choice is yours. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's episode of 7 Good Minutes, we listen in as Jack Canfield talks with us about how to overcome negativity and keep your self-talk positive. Enjoy.
Researchers estimate that we think about 50,000 to 70,000 thoughts a day, and that about 80% of those thoughts are negative. Now, that's a crazy number. We spend so much time telling ourselves that we're not good enough, we're not smart enough, we're not talented enough, or thin enough. We tell ourselves that we don't deserve the things we want, or that the things we want to have or to experience will never happen. And even if they do, they'll probably be disappointing. Our negative self-talk affects us in a very powerful way. If we think something is possible, we're more likely to make the effort to achieve it. If we think it's impossible, we won't even bother trying. If we think we're a good person who deserves to live a life we love, we will create that life. But if we think we're undeserving or not capable enough, we will sabotage our own efforts without even realizing it. Now, studies show that your thoughts also have a physical impact on your body. Take polygraph tests, commonly referred to as lie detector tests, for example. They demonstrate how your thoughts directly influence your blood pressure, your muscle tension, your temperature, your breathing rate, your heart rate, even how much your hands sweat. Now, those are some pretty significant physical reactions to your thoughts. And when you experience the effects of negative thoughts, such as thoughts that create the emotional states of fear, anger, anxiety, guilt, shame, or regret, the muscles in your body actually become weaker. Your stress levels go up. You experience changes in your biochemistry and hormone levels, and you may even suffer from gastrointestinal or digestive problems, among other physical symptoms. Now, studies also show that negative people tend to be more depressed and are generally less satisfied with life. In contrast, when you experience positive thoughts, you flood your brain with endorphins, which helps you relax so you're more alert and centered. Not only that, positive thinking increases your experience of pleasure while reducing physical pain. And as a result, you're far more likely to be confident, optimistic, and motivated to do whatever it takes to achieve your goals. But for some people, shifting their negative thoughts to positive ones is easier said than done. Some people have a lifelong habit of seeing the bad in everything, including themselves. They might try to justify their negativity by pointing out everything bad that's happening in the world and saying they're just being realistic. But in reality, all they're doing is mentally sabotaging themselves. Now, the good news is you are ultimately in control of your thoughts because you are the source of them. That means you can learn to consciously choose to replace your negative thoughts with positive ones that will make your life better. You see, not all negative thoughts are the result of your inner critic run wild. There are other types of negative thinking that if you can learn to identify them and count them, you can create a happier, more successful, more positive, and more fulfilling life. So to help you do that today, I'd like to share 5 of the main types of negative thinking that people do so you can recognize them when they happen and then consciously choose to replace them with something more positive. The first is called always or never thinking. This is when you find yourself thinking in terms of always, never, every time, everyone, no one, and so on. For example, thoughts like, I will never get a raise, or nobody cares about me, or I always screw up no matter what. This type of thinking is not only detrimental to your happiness, it's not based in reality. It's not true that no one cares about you or that you will never get a raise. Well, that last one might be true if you never do the necessary work to get a raise. But then you're the one who is creating that situation, which means that you can change it. It's not an absolute given. Now, the next type of negative thinking is focusing on the negative. I mentioned this before. It's when you're so busy looking at everything that's bad in the world, you can't see the good. But the truth is, life isn't all bad, just as it isn't all good. It's a combination of both. There's a positive side and a negative side to pretty much everything. And since you get to choose what you are going to focus on, why not choose to focus on the positive? I promise you it will have a much better impact on your life and your health if you do. Now, the third type of negative thinking is called catastrophic predicting. This is when you imagine the worst possible outcome in any situation and convince yourself of its inevitability, usually without any real facts to back it up. A good example of this would be that you begin to imagine that you're going to be laid off from work, or that North Korea is going to send a nuclear missile and blow up Los Angeles where you live, even when there's no concrete evidence that supports your prediction. Even though the worst case scenario rarely ever happens, you act like it's just a matter of time and you let it dominate your thoughts and your actions. The truth is, we never know what the future holds, and history shows that worst case scenarios seldom come to pass. So why worry about something that hasn't happened yet, and most likely never will? You're much better off to simply focus on what is actually happening in the current moment and just stay focused on that, such as the task at hand. Now, the fourth type of negative thinking is a sneaky one. I'm talking about mind reading. This is when you tell yourself you know what someone else is thinking, and it's always something bad. Did you ever find yourself having an argument in your head with someone? You imagine them saying all sorts of terrible things that frustrate or anger you, or that hurt you and that make you feel ashamed. That is mind reading. In reality, you have absolutely no idea what that person is thinking, but you tell yourself that you do, and you let this false belief negatively impact your relationships. Remember, most likely you aren't psychic. The only way you can ever truly know what someone else is thinking is to ask them and have an honest conversation about it. That's also how you form deeper, more meaningful relationships.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.